hit bullseye, the kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. Hey boys and girls, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Pass Math with Miss Passarella. I'm your favorite math teacher, Miss Passarella, and before we get started, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and tell me I'm adorable in the comments below. Also, there is a link to the worksheet in the notes I'm using in the comments, and then there's going to be two more videos that kind of go with this one. One will be the quotient law of exponents and power tool power law of exponents, and I'm also going to put those links in the description so that you can kind of follow along with this unit. All right, today we are going to simplify expressions using the product law of exponents, also known as multiplying powers. Mathematicians are like super lazy and they like to come up with shortcuts for everything. That's why we actually have all this math notation and language. So I'm going to show you what the rule is, I'm going to show you why, and then we're just going to continue to use the rule and the shortcut. So the rule we're going to do today again is the product law of exponents. So it's anytime you see an expression being multiplied and they both have an exponent in the same base. So right now I could see that the rule, they both have the base of A, one has an exponent of B, one has an exponent of C, and I can see that they're being multiplied right here. Also, I don't like to use an x for multiplication because then I think it's the x variable. So you can use a times, you can use a star, I like to use. You can use a dot, you can use parentheses. Any one of those things are multiplication. I don't like to use x. All right, so the rule is to keep the base the same and to add the exponents. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to keep my base the same, A. And then I'm going to add my exponents. So B plus C is the exponent. And I'm going to show you why that is in a second. So right here for question two, I have x to the third times x squared. It can't be plus in the middle. And the bases, remember, they have to be the same. It can't be x and y. Then it would just be an order of operations kind of expression. So right now, I'm going to show you out an expanded form. This is called exponential form because you can see that they have exponents. So I'm going to go ahead and expand x to the third and x squared. So x to the third is actually just x being multiplied by itself three times. It's not three times x. So I'm going to put this out as one, two, three x's. And those are all being multiplied by two x's here, so x times x. So this is called expanded form. And when it's expanded, you could see that all the operations in between are multiplication. And so I could just put this into exponential form. So I could see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 x's being multiplied. So I can simplify that like this, x to the fifth power. So if I were going to use the shortcut, because again, this is so much work. What if I had x to the 27th power, something like that? I don't want to sit here and write out 27 x's. That takes too long. So I'm just going to keep my base the same, which is x. And I'm going to add my exponents. So 3 plus 2. And that actually equals x to the fifth power. So you could see when I used the rule and when I did it the long way in expanded form, I got the same answer. All right, next question. So this one has a variable base. It's similar to the one we just did, but I think it's important to go over it again. I'm not going to do expanded form. I'm just going to use the shortcut. I'm going to keep my base of y the same, and I'm going to add my exponents, so 5 plus 7. So now 5 plus 7 is 12, so my answer is y to the 12th power. And I'm done with that one. All right, question 4. There's a lot of room for error with this one. It's actually, the base right now is 3. So you're not going to say 3 times 3 is 9. That wouldn't make any sense, especially if you were to look at this using order of operations, which we're going to do first. And then we're going to apply the rule so that you could see it's shorter and it means the same exact thing. So again, you don't want to do 9 to the 7th power. This is incorrect. Okay, don't do that. I'm going to do it with order of operations first, and then we're going to go ahead and apply the rule. Because I would just look at this normally and say, oh, I could simplify this using order of operations. Okay. So the first way I'm going to do this, again, this is not the rule, it's not the shortcut, is 3 to the fifth times 3 squared. And then I can come over to my calculator and I can do 3 to the fifth, which is 3. You could raise your exponent right here. You could see kind of my arrow. And then raise it to the fifth power, and that is equal to 243. See, I'm already getting annoyed. This is already taking way longer. And then I can do 2 squared, which we all know is 9, but let's do it in our calculator. 2 or 3 to the second power, and that is 9. And now I have to multiply these two terms together. But I'm going to kind of tell you a problem with this method. So now I've got 243 times 9, which is 2187. So this is actually called standard form when you simplify it. Also simplified. And this is nice, but what if the question wanted you to leave it in exponential form? You couldn't get it using this method of order of operations. So I'm actually going to use the product law here, which is the shortcut. Again, don't multiply the threes. The rule states to keep the base the same. So I have 3 to the fifth times 3 squared. Keep your base the same, 3. And now add your exponents. We have 5 plus 2, and 5 plus 2 is 7, so 3 to the seventh power. Now, this is your answer in exponential form. And you can also then go to your calculator and find the expanded or the standard form or simplified form. So I have 3 raised to the seventh power. And I have, look, the same exact answer I had when I did order of operations. It looks like it's longer, but the math is easier. The numbers are easier to work with. So 2187 is the same answer. And I don't like working with those numbers like 243 times 9. I think it's like way more difficult. The steps are too much. I think that the product law is much easier because I'm a mathematician and I'm lazy. All right. I'm going to go over another one here. This is still with a numerical base. I wanted you to see a couple things that this has three terms in it, or not terms, but three different numbers with the base of 4. And if there is no exponent on that last 4, the exponent is actually 1, not 0. Anything to the 0 power is 1, but anything to the first power is just itself. So I'm going to follow the same rules. I don't need to go through order of operations. I think that would take too long here. So I'm just going to follow the shortcut. I've got four, which is the base. Remember, don't say 4 times 4 times 4. Don't do that. Keep the base the same. So I've got 2 plus 3 plus 1. And now I can just add that. 2 plus 3 is 5 plus 1 is 6. So I have 4 to the 6th power. I'm going to come over to my calculator. I've got 4 to the 6th power, and that is 4096. And that one is done. So I think again that the exponent rules are much easier than order of operations in this case. All right, negative exponents. This gets tricky because you have to know your exponent laws, and you also have to know your integer laws because we're going to be like adding and subtracting exponents. So I'm going to treat this the same exact way. That's a z, not a 2. I'll show you how I change that up with my handwriting so you can see the difference. All right, I'm going to keep my base the same. I can see that they're being multiplied in between. So z, and then it's negative 5 plus 7, and that is just z squared. I like to put a little line right here on the z so you know it's a z and not a 2. All right, so this answer is just z squared. All right, this one is actually going to become a fraction. All right, so also this one has a numerical base, so please be careful. Don't say 3 times 3 is 9. That's not how it works. So I'm going to keep my base the same, 3. And I'm going to add the exponents. So negative 5 plus 2. Another error is that people will want to multiply the exponents because it's the product law, and that's not true either. I would not say negative 5 times 2 is negative 10. That's incorrect. So don't multiply the exponents. That's a different rule. Right now, if they're being multiplied, remember you keep your base the same, you add your exponents. So negative 5 plus 2 is negative 3. So there's a couple different answers that I can have. 3 to the negative third is a good answer, but I want to write this using positive exponents only, and then I also want to simplify it. So if I were going to rewrite it as a positive exponent, you would just take the reciprocal. So right now it's on the numerator, and the negative exponential law says that you just take the reciprocal and make it positive, so I can write it as 1 over 3 to the third. And then I can also simplify that even more. This is exponential form, but if I wanted to simplify it, I would say 1 over 3 to the third is actually 27. So that would be in the simplest form. But a lot of times when you are applying the laws of exponents, they want you to write them using positive exponents in your answer. So that would be the most appropriate answer out of all three answers here. All right. The last set is the trickiest. These are called monomials. You can see that they are a combination of numbers, variables, and bases. So I want to go over that the 6 and the 4 are not considered bases in this case. They're actually just coefficients. They could be bases if they were the same, but we're not going to treat them like that. We're just going to treat them like coefficients. And we're going this there's one extra step here. So before our steps were keep the base the same and add the exponents, but right now I'm going to add an extra step in there, and step one is going to be multiply coefficient. And then step two is going to be keep the base the same, and that's only for the variable. Keep the base same, and then the third is the same as the second step for when there was no coefficient, and that is to add the exponents. So let's go ahead and follow all those rules. So step one, let's multiply those coefficients. You don't have to show all the work I'm going to show now, but I'm just going to do it so you can see all the pieces, and then we'll put it together afterwards. Where you don't have to show as much work. So 6 times 4 is 24. I'm going to keep my base the same. The base is x or the variable. And then I'm going to add the exponents. So x and then 7 plus 3 is x to the 10th. And now I can put it all together. The answer is 24 x to the 10th. But you can literally go from here to here without showing any work, and that's acceptable. That's why we actually have the law. So you can just go 6 times 4 is 24, write that there, keep your base the same, and then kind of add the exponents in your head, and then put the answer down. All right, this one's a little bit trickier. It's got a few more numbers and variables in it. All right, come on. All right, so I'm going to go through the same rules. I'm going to multiply the coefficients, keep the bases the same, and add the exponents, but I'm going to do them all kind of separately so we don't get confused. So first step, I'm going to multiply negative 7 times 5, which is negative 35. I'm going to keep the base a the same. So I have a and then 4 plus 1. So if there's no exponent on that a, the exponent is 1, and then 4 plus 1 is 5, so that's a to the fifth power. Now let's take a look at the b, and then again, there's no exponent on b, so I'm going to say to the first power. So I have b to the 1 plus 4 equals b to the fifth, and then the last variable is c. And I've got c to the third power plus to the second power. So that is c to the 3 plus 2, which is 5. So now I can just write this in a row. I like to keep the variables in alphabetical order, but that's just me. You won't always see it that way. So I'm going to put negative 35, a to the 5th, oops, b to the 5th, and c to the 5th. And so that is my entire answer. All right, boys and girls, I hope this was helpful. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and tell me I'm adorable. And please leave a comment below if you have any questions, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Bye-bye. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.